Hello everyone, I'm Mexican Base Monkey.
And I'm NTom64.
And this is the Donkey Kong Country playthrough.
Oh yeah, I've been wanting to get this series on HellfireComms for the longest time. And we were kind of scrambling, like a monkey trying to get bananas from a tree, to use a really, really apt metaphor, for content for the end part of the year. So I thought, hell, might as well do some DKC.
If I had my say, we were just going to do commentaries on a bunch of movies. It would have been like the Saw movie or, I don't know, something by one of those shitty Woods movies. But that's why I'm not in charge. Instead, I had the joyous pleasure of recording this game. And I guess a little background into my history with Donkey Kong Country. Growing up, I didn't play it.
Mm-hmm.
Not at all.
Yeah.
I had cousins who had it. I had friends who had it. But me, myself, I rarely, if ever, got to play this game. But growing up, I watched it a lot. And then, obviously, in recent years, I would watch speedruns of it.
Yep,
and
yep.
Only until, like, about a year or two ago did I actually start playing this game.
I actually started with the second game, Donkey Kong Country 2, Diddy's Kong Quest. Not Conquest, Kong's Quest. And I've completed this maybe once, at a push, twice. So I'm like least knowledgeable about this one, so Mexi probably will be taking the reins for the most part, but he recorded the game, so that's just natural, I guess.
Yeah, I'm least knowledgeable about 3, so we kind of balance each other. I know more about 1, you know, 3, and then we have an even ground on 2.
Yeah.
But Donkey Kong Country, alright, so it's a game about rolling monkeys.
Of course.
If you press the roll button, you do a roll. If you roll into an enemy, you get a second roll. If you roll off a ledge, you get a second roll. So, a lot of the gameplay about going fast and getting through levels efficiently is about maintaining rolls by extending them into either jumps or into enemies.
Yeah, that sounds suspiciously like momentum, Maxi.
Yeah, well, I was going to bring this up a lot later, but I remember that a lot of Sonic fans, when they talk about the classic games, like what makes them so good is that speed is a reward. Like you have to work for it, and then to maintain it requires being good at the game. I honestly feel that that's something that Donkey Kong Country does and does better. Speed is a genuine reward. You can get through these levels completely slow by stopping and jumping on enemies, but in order to maintain speed at all times throughout the levels, you have to know the level, you have to know where enemies are, and you have to be accurate on when you want to start your rolls.
It feels a bit iffy if you try and do it like stop and start, because enemies will exploit though.
They do, and they start to get a lot smarter later on. They were really good about programming enemies with AIs that affect your movement. You're going to see that there are enemies that are built around when you jump. There are enemies that are placed right after areas where they explicitly put, like, roll extenders. Like, they'll put 5 enemies, which the only reason to do that is to give you a really, really long roll. And then put, like, a pit at the end. So it's like, sucka, got fooled.
Those assholes. Now, is this going to be a 100% run or an any percent run?
Well, 100% in Donkey Kong Country is actually 101. There are, I believe it's 2 extra bonus stages, and the whole more than 100% kind of carries on to all later Donkey Kong Country games, even 64. But I'm going to call this max percent.
Okay.
Essentially, I'm going to do all levels, and I'm going to do all bonus stages along the way. However, there are some levels where I won't be going in the direction of a bonus stage, so I'm not going to get it. So there's no backtracking, but I'm going to get everything along the way.
That's fine, as long as there's a nice flow, I guess. Donkey Kong Country is best when you're on a flow, after all. And here he is, the original Donkey Kong, at about time too.
Yeah, when he's not making memes on Twitter, Cranky Kong is sitting in a rocking chair in the cabin in the woods.
Fucking base Nintendo UK, I swear. Or was that Nintendo of America? The UK one's better, regardless.
Well, the UK, they're the ones that are tweeting all the Majora's Mask pics now, aren't they?
Hells yeah.
Lovely. But yeah, Cranky Kong is the original arcade Donkey Kong. Before, it was sort of like a joke theory, or that maybe Donkey Kong just got a makeover, but no. Cranky Kong is the Donkey Kong that kidnaps Pauline and that Jumpman has to go save later, mm-hmm. named Mario had to go save. He is not Donkey Kong's father, he is Donkey Kong's grandfather. Donkey Kong Jr. is Donkey Kong's father.
Ah.
In later games, there are things about Donkey Kong Jr. that Donkey Kong, the present one, doesn't really know his dad, which is kind of sad. But that the most that he knows is what Cranky Kong has told him about his dad, and that Donkey Kong Jr. would save his papa. So it's like, ah, really, guys, you gotta make this all sappy and heartwarming?
I'm kind of just sitting here dumbfounded that Donkey Kong has really deep lore, and not a kind of joking way.
It's kind of hilarious, too. Diddy Kong was originally designed to be Donkey Kong Jr., but what happened was they had the design, so they didn't really change what he looks like. He had the hat, the t-shirt, and everything, but what happened was when Rare showed the concept to Nintendo, they were like, wow, this looks way too different from the original Donkey Kong Jr., so you either need to change him to more back to his original design, or just make him a new character, which, honestly, that's what they should have done from the first place.
What is his relation to Donkey Kong? Because I always knew him as Donkey's nephew.
Okay, so, first of all, Donkey Kong and Diddy Kong are not related.
Okay.
One, because he's a gorilla, and Diddy's a monkey. They're not even in the same species. They're not even on the same side of the Earth. Gorillas are mostly in the Old World, and Diddy has a prehensile tail, so it's a tail that grabs stuff. Those only exist in monkeys that live in South America.
Okay, fair enough, Mr. Encyclopedia Britannica. Can I just give a quick shout-out to Aquatic Ambience here? One of the best tracks in Donkey Kong as a whole, country or otherwise.
It definitely is. Unfortunately, I kind of get through these levels a bit too quickly for it to get to the good part. They're on guard, the fish here. He's in pretty much all of the aquatic levels, and he's your means of going through quickly and also to give yourself one free hit. That is the thing about Donkey Kong Country. You start off with like 6 lives, and with most old platformers, that's a lot. Usually the standard is 2-3, but you start with 6. And a reason for that is because this game has a one-shot, one-kill. You start with Donkey Kong, and there's an enemy right there. If you don't know your jumps or rolls, you will lose a life right off the bat. But that's not too outlandish. I mean, you start Mario, walk into a Goomba, dead. Your closest thing to a power-up is getting Diddy, and all he provides you is a free hit.
I prefer playing as Diddy, to be honest, because Donkey Kong was always just a bit too sluggish for me, as powerful as he is.
Yeah, that was something I was going to say when I first got Diddy, is that we are now going to be playing Diddy Kong Country, because Diddy suffers from Luigi syndrome. He jumps higher, runs further, and is all around better suited for a platformer, however, he's second banana.
Just not right.
Yep, so I will be playing as Diddy for the entire playthrough. Except bosses, because those don't require you to actually maneuver too much, so Donkey Kong has an advantage. Donkey Kong does have gameplay advantage. There are some enemies that Diddy cannot jump or roll into to kill that Donkey Kong can. But the game is really nice and will usually have barrels nearby, so that even if you lose Donkey and you only have Diddy, you know, the game will still provide you a way. So it's like, at that point, fuck using Donkey Kong. Sure, he has Hand Slap, but I don't even use that.
Now, you mentioned bosses there. What's the story in this game? Because we're coming up to a boss right now, I think.
Okay, so the story is only in the pamphlet. Like, when I saw that there was a backstory, I was like, oh shit, did I skip a cutscene? No, the story is in the pamphlet. What it is that one night, Donkey Kong tells Diddy that he's in charge of guarding the banana hoard as part of his hero training. So Diddy is going through hero's training. Yes, this is hilarious. And what happens is that while this happens, the Kremlings crew, who are all, they're the baddies, they kidnap Donkey Kong's bananas.
Okay.
Yes, Donkey Kong Country is the story of a primate and his familial relatives and their journey to reacquire their hoard of potassium.
Yeah, and this is just a smidgen of the actual hoard, so you can just imagine how many bananas there actually are.
There's a lot. So what happened was when they steal all the bananas, they also trap Diddy in a barrel, and then Donkey wakes up because Cranky's like, yo, lazy sucker, wake up. And that's when Donkey Kong talks in the pamphlet prelude. He's like, well, it's business time or some shit. I don't know the actual quote. I may have to look it up later, but it's... That's the story, is Donkey Kong's stuff gets stolen, and he's gonna go get it back. It's 50 Cent Blood on the Sand, but even better.
I can't believe I wanted, like, cable TV back in the day to be able to watch the Donkey Kong Country cartoon on Fox Kids. I only got a chance to watch it, like, I would say a year or so ago when the Gaming Brit linked me to an episode, and needless to say, I hate him now for subjecting me to that.
But it's so great. I mean, you see Donkey Kong riding around in his fancy car.
Shut the fuck up, Mexico. Shut the fuck up. Okay, I actually really like these little animal buddy sections, especially finding the giant golden ones.
Yeah, the buddy stages, if you get three of any golden animal buddy statue, you get to that respective animal's bonus stage.
Mm-hmm.
And it's pretty much gather as many shiny statues as possible, and as you said, there is one giant golden statue in every bonus stage that when you hit it, it will double the amount of statues you already have. I don't get it in this one, just because, I don't know, I just didn't bother getting it, but in later playthroughs, I will do later bonus stages, and I will be getting the golden statue. But, and on top of that, I want to say the bonus room blitz, the track playing in the bonus rooms, was probably my favorite song that I remembered before I actually played through the game, like, extensively. Because I remember there was one time when I was a kid, it was after Brawl came out, so I wasn't super young, but it had been a while since I had seen Donkey Kong Country. And for some reason, in the middle of the store, I had a song stuck in my head. It's like, wait, that's a Donkey Kong Country song. I know it is. And I thought it was the first levels track. So, I don't know. I guess I looked up on Brawl, or on Smash Bros. Brawl OST, because I figured that's probably why it's stuck in my head. No. Bonus Room Blitz was the song I had in my head.
For a second there, I thought you were committing seppuku.
No. Levels can be skipped. There are a lot of levels within the first three worlds that can just be outright skipped. The first one being the first minecart. You know, something that is heavily attributed to Donkey Kong.
Yeah.
And all his games are minecarts. But the very first minecart level in Donkey Kong Country can just be outright skipped.
This would actually get kind of worse in my favorite of the Country games, the third game, where you can basically, I think it's in the first two worlds, skip over almost every single level.
The first three worlds of Donkey Kong Country 3 all have a warp barrel to the end of the level.
Jesus.
Yeah, and that's what I mean when I say max percent, is that luckily with that last minecart level, there are no bonus rooms, but if I do end up skipping a level, I'm not going back to getting the bonus stages I missed. So that's where, you know, the remaining percentage that I don't get comes from.
Ah, so gotta go fast, Strauss, then.
Kind of gotta go fast while still being entertaining. The reason I'm getting all the bonus stages is because at first when I recorded World 1, just going through, not even bothering getting all the bonus stages, World 1 ended up being like 7 minutes. I was like, oh, yeah, I'm gonna have to fix that. Zinkers are pretty much, I remember them being the worst enemy in the whole game, but eventually you grow out of it and you learn their patterns and they're just pathetic at that point.
They're almost a mainstay in the series. I think they get changed to mechanical versions in the third game, like green and red varieties.
Yeah, the Zingers, there's a variety of them in this game too. There's like a green, dark brown, and a red one. And me and a friend keep getting a conversation where we're not quite entirely sure whether they're bees, hornets, yellow jackets, or wasps.
Huh.
Yeah. Also, Stop and Go Station, a level that most people I hear say is like the first hard level of the game, and that, oh, it's so frustrating. Yeah, I don't see why. I don't get it.
You're straight OG, mate. That was a really, really flowing kind of run.
I know, and it's built like an Insomnia Spyro game. Where's the warp point? Just go backwards. Go back to the entrance.
I think you mean Insomniac, mate, but I did develop a little bit of insomnia staying up finding gems that were positioned right behind level entrances, so it's appropriate, I suppose.
And that's the only one that does that, so I think it's really clever and unique for that. Like, because you walk through a doorway. It makes sense when you think about it, but because it's in a video game, you don't think about that.
You gotta be careful because there's some enemies that only Donkey can jump on.
In addition to that, there are actually certain barrels that only Donkey Kong can get. That warp barrel is Donkey Kong exclusive. That's why I had to switch.
Alright, boss time. Man, two worlds down already.
Not quite boss time. First, we gotta get some advice from Cranky Kong.
Hit him. Hit him a lot.
Okay, Kroll Caper was a couple minutes ago, but still helpful, thank you. Yeah, Espresso. Already been through that too. Anything new, Cranky? Guess not.
Always nice to stop in and see the grandparents.
Boss fight known as Necky's Nuts.
I love the animation on this guy. I don't know why. One of my favorite comedic tropes is something coming in from off screen. Like very, very... What's the word I'm looking for? Silly. Yeah, it's very silly-like.
It's a visual gag, which, you know, you would expect that a lot from video games, but nope. And he's an easy boss, just jump on his head and don't get hit by coconuts. get your banana, and that's World 2.
Okay, guys, we'll see you next time for more Donkey Kong Country. Bye-bye for now.